Here are 30 online reviews of the audiobook titled, Born a Crime. Written and narrated by Trevor Noah. 1. Everyone should listen to this. Wow. This is by far the best audiobook I've ever heard, and one of the best books I've ever read. It made me laugh. It made me cry. It made me think. Trevor brings such a unique worldview, and even though his life was so much different than mine, there was still so much I could relate to. I learned so much listening to this, about apartheid, race, poverty, and the power of language. Excellently performed, obviously. It feels less like a book and more like Trevor is just telling his story. I listened to the outhouse/blind grandma chapter while I was at the gym and I literally had to stop working out for a couple minutes because I was laughing so hard. This is the gold standard of audiobooks. It's 100% worth a listen, and a re-listen. So good. 2. Nonchalant comments about animal abuse. I'm from South Africa and Trevor's account of South Africa was spot on, but frankly I stopped listening after his unemotional account of animal abuse towards his own cats. Made me feel sick to my stomach. Trevor just lost a fan for life. 3. Amazing. I love stories. I believe stories are what bring people together, how we can learn to see the commonalities between us all. I love this audiobook. Trevor Noah takes us through his journey growing up, the insights he learned from his family, mainly his mother, with a comedy twist at every corner and thoughtful wisdom throughout this book. I highly recommend. Go ahead, treat yourself to this audiobook, it's worth it, guaranteed. 4. An interesting take on life, yet a bit disturbing. As someone who is blind, I love Audible because the books are narrated to me. I made this selection because I enjoy listening to the writer on his comedy show. He is very entertaining and can tell a good story. For the most part, I find his commentary is generally on point. This book gives you a glimpse into his mind and gives you a little background about the life that he has had while growing up in South Africa. I found the issues regarding domestic violence and his family situation to be quite disturbing, but I understand where his viewpoint is coming from because it was a very terrible situation. There were many things in the book that were quite funny and I enjoyed much of his narrative. I had a little bit of a problem with the story regarding the time where he was a DJ and had a lead dancer who was given the name of Hitler. His explanation of the situation and the reason why this person was named after one of the most notorious people in history is uncomfortable. Other than these two things, I would recommend this book to others with the caveat that it might be a little much for some. 5. Fine, but Noah is engaging. And his self-depreciating assessment of childhood is familiar to all who have experienced it, regardless of race or country. His observations on race in South Africa and the world over are insightful, but during one anecdote he essentially blames his two pet cats' natural temperament for their own sadistic murder, beheading, and skinning at the hands of a superstitious neighbor. In that sense, it seems he may have learned a lot about people's nature, but not much about animals in general. 6. All about a naughty boy. I was interested in the cultural aspect of Noah's early life, but when he went on and on about how naughty he was, I lost interest. Naughty boys are naughty boys all over the world. I may go back and try to listen again as I would like to know how he became the person he is today. 7. Good, but watch out. This is an incredible story of growing up in apartheid and we can only imagine what people endured. Trevor's mother was a remarkable individual. My caveat is that this must have 100 plus F-bombs, 100 plus S-bombs, and I did not appreciate his endearing reference to pornography. In today's day and age of abuse, we should teach our children not to succumb to viewing women as a commodity. That totally ruined this otherwise remarkable tale. 8. Interesting topic, badly executed. Where was editor for this work? Arrogant, egotistical, not even very funny, this guy has an overblown idea of himself that ruined the potential for what could have been an interesting story. Informative read. I will not recommend this and am sorry I wasted my invested time in it. Refuse to even finish it. Refund please. 9. Not as funny as I expected. Trevor Noah, known for his comedic chops, turns introspective here, blending stories from his own childhood with social commentary on both South Africa and the United States. While humorous much of the time, the text and Noah's performance are not laugh out loud funny. That's not to say that I didn't enjoy spending time with Trevor as he reminisces about the people and circumstances that shaped his life. His talent for language and mimicry bring the characters of his youth alive for his listeners. From poverty few Americans understand to tremendous success in the public eye. Trevor recounts the steady determination of his mother that he not have to pay the debt for the shortcomings of the society he was born into. For anyone interested in other cultures that we don't often hear about in the US, Noah's story is a fascinating glimpse into the world of a people at once strange and distressingly familiar. 10. It is just biography, boring. I love Trevor Noah, and I didn't check reviews when I was adding the book. This book is boring, it is biography of his life. First chapters are okay, then you say alright, it is good to know how his life was, but then you see OMG, the rest are long and boring. I felt like everyone can write a book like this. I wish chapters were brief. The only reason I am still listening to book is because I don't like leaving a book unfinished. 11. Good story if you don't mind the F word. Thought I had a winner until he got into a 10 to 15 minute dissertation on shitting. Downhill from there. After 12 chapters I couldn't take the frequent F words anymore. Author is articulate, highly intelligent and engaging otherwise. He's a rebel and one feels he takes no little amount of pride in that. Got the impression that he was attributing more of his sufferings to apartheid than was deserved even for such an inhuman practice. Sometimes people do the wrong thing just because they don't care and the fault lies with them and not with the policy they're under. 12. I didn't hate it. In fact, I didn't feel passionately about it at all. Some of the stories were repetitive and it was difficult to discern what period of his life he was talking about at any particular moment because he jumps back and forth quite a lot. I also expected it to be a funnier. The only bit that I really found funny was the story about him doing number two in the kitchen. Overall, this book doesn't live up to the hype. I don't think I would recommend it to anyone unless they were a fan of Trevor's to begin with. I did enjoy hearing about his individual experience growing up in South Africa during apartheid, but the disjointedness kept this from being a really good listen for me. 13. Good. But not great. A good story about Trevor's life in South Africa. I can't give it 5 stars because Trevor is a stand-up comedian slash talk show host, so the book is loaded with lots of schlick. Probably a kernel of truth in some of it, but probably he reconstructed things for comedic effect. Some funny. Some not. Also, when he got serious he seemed to like animal abuse stories. Overall a pretty good read, but people around the world who've seen his stand-up routine have heard every joke. 14. I like him, but this was the first time I've ever listened to an audiobook. I am a fairly avid reader, so this was different for me and maybe that affected my opinion of this story. I'm glad I read slash heard it. I learned a lot about apartheid and South African people and prejudices, but I didn't enjoy the story as a whole. Not very uplifting, I found most of the situations and people frustrating. I found some anecdotes funny, but overall I wasn't that interested in much of it and my mind would drift. It's admirable how he got himself out of that country to where he is today, and I'm happy for him and his success. 15. I feel educated, humbled, and inspired. Trevor Noah has a gift for telling a bald-faced, terrifying truth, in a way that makes it feel approachable, knowable, and in doing that it no longer seems unconquerable. This glimpse into a complicated world that is equally foreign and yet resonates with aspects of my own childhood experience. His mother's bravery and his ability to move through that experience is truthful in a way that lends itself to discovery. Thankful for the experience. 16. The mystery of Trevor explained. I've been enjoying Trevor's wisdom, comedy, and insights for years, but I've always wondered where this funny, wise sage came from. Here it is, the story of how Trevor was created, piece by piece. His knack for languages, accents, and culture did not happen by accident. He was forged in the fires of apartheid, poverty, crime, and family hardships. This is an incredible story, told perfectly by the author. 17. You'll laugh, you'll cry. Trevor Noah narrates his story of his life in South Africa. From the details of his mother's relentless spirit, to hustling his way through adolescence, he paints a hilarious and heartfelt picture. After listening to this on audiobook, I will definitely be getting the novel to add to my collection. I had no idea about his story other than him being a comedian. 10 stars if I could. 18. Unexpected and educational. I started this book not knowing anything about Trevor Noah except that I had seen him on TV in passing. I am so glad I read it because there were so many things I didn't know. I left it educates, humbled, and with a deep respect for Trevor, but more so his rock of a mother. She inspired me the most. Her forward thinking was completely admirable. I would recommend this book for her alone. I loved it. 19. A great listen. I am such a fan of Trevor Noah and The Daily Show, and he brings the same honesty, insight, and humor to this reading. His life stories are fascinating, at times jaw-dropping. The narration is great with the voicing of different characters. Trevor Noah really shows his mastery of language, and languages. I loved listening to this on my commute and highly recommend Born a Crime. 20. Nothing like I expected it to be. I went into this book thinking this was gonna be a story about how Trevor became a comedian. Trevor's story is one that needs to be heard through his voice so you can understand all the context and people to their fullest. I felt like I was growing up with him and my heart just kept breaking but mending knowing how successful he has become and seems to have remained so grounded. This book was incredible and I just wish I could give them all a big hug and say thank you for sharing your story. Would love to hear the story of how Trevor got into comedy and his journey to The Daily Show and how he feels now. 21. Riveting autobiography. I have followed Trevor Noah for several years, enjoying all of his comedy acts and his Daily Show, especially during the pandemic lockdown. I appreciate his intelligence and wit. I was aware that he had a difficult life before he attained international success, but I never suspected just how hard it really was. This collection of autobiographical sketches brings to life the challenging experiences of a mixed-race person in South Africa in the tumultuous transitional years after apartheid was abolished. Trevor is the ideal narrator for his life story and fleshes out the characters with different voices and languages. This is one of his best performances ever and not to be missed. 22. I couldn't stop listening. This was such an amazing book. I laughed a lot as I empathized with all of Trevor's trials and tribulations. This narrative makes so much sense as to who he is and why he is so qualified to speak the way he does. I wish more people could see life through his lens. His mother is a rock. I'd like to have my children honor me in such life. A must read for sure. 23. Exceptional story of an exceptional life. A fantastic book about the challenges of growing up in post-apartheid South Africa by an incredible talent. It's said that hardship breeds comedy, and there's no exception here. Thankfully, Trevor seems to have weathered the storm of his life to become one of the greatest comedic talents of our time. This book is an excellent roller coaster of emotions, filled with amazing and unbelievable stories. I'm more glad now having read this that Trevor has gone on to the great heights that he has for our enjoyment, and even more so that he seems to maintain his sanity after experiencing the world as he has. 24. Honestly written and well spoken. I had somewhat lower expectations for this audiobook. I thought it was going to be overhyped by his fans. I'm not a super fan of his show so I was ambivalent about listening. I found his book to be so honest and matter-of-fact about his life experiences. There was no sugarcoating about the difficulties of growing up in South Africa. I finished it within 1.5 days which is pretty surprising because I usually get distracted or bored easily. His stories about his mother were just expectational and hilarious. I think the only thing I found difficult was that he skips back and forth on his stages of life between chapters, so I'd be confused at first. At times I'd have to rewind a bit because of this. Is this a book I'd listen to again? Probably not. But overall it was a great audiobook and I'm glad I listened to it. 25. Trevor Noah is truly gifted. Trevor Noah is truly gifted at storytelling, surviving, connecting with people and bringing us into his young world, a life and culture not seen by millions and millions of people. Trevor's mother might reflect that her son's experiences were used to bring people to Jesus. I'd add that Trevor's life was given a voice to open eyes. My mom would have loved hearing Trevor Noah share his stories as she became more aware of our untold American history. 26. What an enlightening and enjoyable story. I thoroughly enjoyed listening to Born a Crime. Even just the title is already great as it is intriguing and invites you to discover its full meaning. And the book certainly provides the explanation with all of its nuances and implications. I loved the undercurrent of humor in Trevor Noah's telling of his sometimes horrific childhood and youth. I loved the homage he pays his mother throughout the book. She is painted in such detail that I feel I know her, admire her and actually love her. What is there not to love about such a strong, independent, and generous woman? But I think what clinches my absolute admiration for this audible book is Noah's narration. I don't know how wonderfully entertaining the book could be if read as a book on paper. Noah's vocal impressions of all the quoted characters was a great part of the fun of listening to the book. Thank you for my wonderful and enjoyable experience. 27. Loved every bit of this book. Trevor did a wonderful job bringing me into his childhood, describing what life was like growing up in South Africa. He also shed light on what it was like, living there, as a person to be of mixed race. As an American, it was interesting to hear his point of view and the realities of his daily life. I highly recommend this book. 28. Phenomenal book. Who would ever think that this delightful man had a life as a child and young adult that was filled with poverty, abuse, loss, and racism? Trevor Noah's story is moving and inspirational. While reading this book, I had feelings about how terrible humans can be and then was also able to see the beauty in life and people. This book was very easy to listen to. Trevor Noah's combination of humor, humility, honesty, and genuineness is felt throughput. His voice is melodic and intoxicating, often this is not the case with audiobooks. This book made me reflect on how life is beautiful but living is sometimes so hard to do. Trevor Noah is a perfect example of this. I have learned a lot from his story and am grateful to Trevor for sharing it with the world. 29. 4.5 over 5. This was super interesting but definitely had the burden of doing a lot of heavy lifting in the history department. I thought he explained apartheid from a really fascinating, more modern perspective and did a good job of really hammering in how important education and language is. This was more of a 4 for me throughout, but the very last chapter and every mention of his mom really stole the show for me. Some things I would have changed were how the chapters at time got a little choppy, especially towards the end. I also wish he would have ordered the chapters a bit more chronologically, even though I could keep track of things, I think it would have been nicer not to keep jumping back and forth. I also would have liked to see the book kinda round out his life into how he gained success, which he barely touched on, at least in an afterword for those who aren't super familiar with his career. I also liked how he spoke about his heavily religious upbringing, but wish he would have opened up more about where he stands with those beliefs now. Disclaimer, this has very intense scenes of domestic violence, but I thought it was told with honesty, compassion, and reflection. 30. Beautiful narration, heart-wrenching yet funny. Loved it, one of the few books I finished within few days, a personal achievement. I am a huge fan of Trevor Noah, his narration adds so much life to the characters and the story. A beautiful read peeking into the ever-evolving yet strongly rooted relationship of Trevor with his mother while growing up during apartheid in South Africa. Trevor is amazing. Thank you for watching. Please, do not forget to subscribe, like and share this video. Tune in for more online audiobooks reviews.